Wednesday, November 16th, at the Azerbaijan Media Center in Baku, Amnesty International presented its new report, The Spring That Never Blossomed, Freedom Suppressed in Azerbaijan. Amnesty International's Azerbaijan researcher Natalia Nozadze reported that the organization had added 17 people involved in the spring protests in Baku to its list of prisoners of conscience and has requested their immediate release. Inspired by mass protests in the Middle East and North Africa, Baku saw smaller, peaceful protests that were organized via social media last spring. However, the Azerbaijan authorities responded harshly to this mild show of dissatisfaction, prohibiting protests and harassing and arresting bloggers and activists. According to the Natalia Nozadze, Amnesty International's Azerbaijan researcher, the clampdown sent a clear message to Azerbaijan activists and ordinary citizens. Following the protests, 14 activists and members of opposition political parties were convicted of organizing and participating in public disorder, charges that led to prison sentences up to 3 years. Amnesty International has stated that there is no evidence that any of the imprisoned opposition supporters were engaged in anything more than the legitimate exercise of their right to freedom of expression and association in seeking to organize peaceful protests in central Baku. The circumstances behind the arrest of APFP activist Shahin Asenli and human rights activist Vidadi Iskandarov, charged with the weapons possession and electoral interference respectively, also suggest that they were prosecuted due to their participation in the protests. John Dahlhausen, the head of the European Division of Amnesty International, also mentioned that youth activists Jab Barsavalan and Bakhtiar Hajiyev were already considered prisoners of conscience by Amnesty International and said that tough measures against protesters were characteristic of despotic regimes. He also commented on the failure of economic prosperity and stability to lead to the protection of fundamental freedoms for the citizens of Azerbaijan. He added that over 20 years, only a skeleton of democracy has been created in Azerbaijan, but there is no meat on the bones, and further described the human rights situation in Azerbaijan. There is an opposition but cannot act effectively. Newspapers are published, but they are afraid of the consequences of what they write. NGOs can act, but any time they can be deprived of registration. Nozadze added that the situation with freedom of expression is deteriorating. People who criticize the authorities are persecuted no matter where they do it, in the media or through social networks. She also mentioned the authorities' use of defamation law to silence critics. Additionally, she noted the forced closure of several NGOs in Ganja and the suspension of the country's two international NGOs, the U.S. National Democratic Institute and the Norwegian Human Rights House. Amnesty International intends to conduct an international campaign to press international organizations, particularly the UN, Council of Europe and the EU, to act on the deteriorating human rights and civil liberties situation in Azerbaijan. With regard to Azerbaijan's refusal to allow the PACE rapporteur on political prisoners to visit the country, Dahlhausen called it a violation of the principles of the Council of Europe. He said that even in the midst of the Chechen War, Russia didn't interfere with the PACE rapporteur visits to the region. He called on the European Assembly to take urgent measures to ensure the mission of the speaker. The Amnesty International report put forward a number of recommendations. In particular, it calls on the authorities to put an end to harassment against citizens and organizations for political reasons, to immediately release all prisoners of conscience, to investigate the harassment of activists, to create a safe environment for human rights defenders, lawyers, journalists, to decriminalize libel, to ensure freedom of the internet, to allow international media to resume broadcasting, and to respect freedom of assembly and expression. It's noteworthy that the Azerbaijan authorities refused to meet with Amnesty International, saying that the visit came at an inappropriate time.
I believe that Amnesty released a very valid report. It covered all problems and all the different angles and issues with the freedom of expression in Azerbaijan. I hope that Amnesty International will increase its support in this direction. Also, I did not read all of the report. I am familiar with it. Unfortunately, I found some shortcomings in the report dealing with the detail in which Amnesty investigated the detentions. The main shortcomings are the report did not cover several issues. For example, there is information on detainees in the report, but there are no details on the circumstances of detentions, the trial, and on the treatment of the arrested activists in prison. The report provided information about the opinion of lawyers and human rights defenders. The report showed that not only we but also general organizations can see these problems. Not only local and international organizations in Azerbaijan, but also international organizations abroad can see the situation of human rights in Azerbaijan.